Food. Most of us take it for granted, but to be where we are today as a food self-sufficient nation, we had to walk a long path. In this journey, standardization played a pivotal role in the whole value chain. From the way we grow our food to the way we consume it, we need proper standards. The basic purposes of establishing food standards are protection of public health, promoting fair trade, prevent misleading product, and to enable consumers to make informed choice. The Food and Agriculture Department, or FAD under the BIS, formulates Indian standards for food, feed, and agriculture produce, covering the entire food supply chain. The Food and Agriculture Division Council, FADC, oversees and supervises its work. Food and Agriculture Department, through the process of standard formulation, promotes various sustainable development goals adopted by United Nations member state. The FADC has 28 sectional committees for standard making. They work through a process of consensus. These technical committees have more than 800 technical experts. A total of 2100 standards have been published under FAD, and more than 60% of these are product specifications.
During past 5 years, we have been able to set several new standards and also modify several standards totaling more than 350. And different committees which have been constituted include experts who work in those domains, have a rich experience. FADC has been continuously trying to improvise upon the existing ones, bringing in required revisions and also creating new standards wherever required. While doing so, it is also taking into account the new developments with regard to technology, how new technology can be used, how industry and its business can be greatly facilitated, and also at the same time how we can satisfy the requirements of consumers and the environmental safety requirements in the process.
As a policy, while developing any Indian standard, BIS technical committees try to align the standard with the international standards to the extent possible, keeping in view the specific Indian conditions, particularly with respect to technology, geographical and climatic considerations. FAD, through its team of experts in various technical committees, participates in the process of development of international standards in international standards bodies like ISO. This ensures that Indian viewpoints and concerns get appropriately addressed while international standards are being developed. This makes adoption of Indian standards better in the Indian context. For ease of understanding regarding the standards formulated by BIS in the area, we have classified the entire standardization activity into 7 groups. The first group, that is agriculture management, it covers standardization in the area of fertilizers, pesticides, agricultural machinery, irrigation, organic farming, agricultural practices. The second group, which is agricultural produce, covers standardization in the area of food grains, spices, condiments, oils, oil seeds, tobacco, etc. In the area of animal husbandry and animal derived food products, BIS has formulated standards relating to animal feeds, dairy, meat, fish and poultry. The next is the food processing sector. Here standards have been formulated on fruit and vegetable products, stimulant foods, ready-to-eat foods, alcoholic beverages and food additives. Standards have also been formulated for various types of packaged waters and drinking water, including water purification systems. The sixth group covers the important area of food hygiene and safety, covering FSMS, HACCP and other hygienic practices to be followed by food business. BIS has also initiated work on standardization in the area of Ayush, which includes Ayurveda and other Indian system of medicines and yoga.
Soil works for you if you work for the soil. Soil management practices help to improve soil health, increase productivity and profitability. Soil is a living factory of macroscopic and microscopic workers who need food to eat and places to live to do their work. Interestingly, there are more microorganisms in a teaspoon of soil than there are people on earth. These microorganisms are usually beneficial for solubilizing or mobilizing the micro and micronutrients and help in making them available for better plant productivity.
Indian standards on fertilizer, including biofertilizer, have been developed by BIS. For instance, the Indian standard IS 8268 specifies the requirement for rhizobium inoculants for certain legume crops. Rhizobium fixes the atmospheric nitrogen, hence they reduce the dependency of the crop on application of chemical fertilizer. Besides legume crops, the Indian standard IS 9138 specifies requirement for Azotobacter species inoculant, which fix atmospheric nitrogen non-symbiotically and may be used for non-legume crops. Another important standard is IS 14807, phosphate solubilizing bacterial inoculants. These standards specify the minimum viable count of cell of microorganism used per gram of carrier base. There are two Indian standards on manure, IS 16556 and IS 16702, municipal solid waste compost, manure grade and vermicompost respectively. These standards specify requirement of bulk density, electrical conductivity, carbon nitrogen ratio, heavy metals and pH. Application of good quality municipal solid waste compost as per Indian standard increase soil productivity by providing nutrients and by improving drainage and moisture absorption. On the contrary, application of bad quality compost can lead to heavy metal toxicity and immobilization of nitrogen in the soil.
After soil health, we come to Indian standards formulated on machinery and equipment used in agriculture. In this important area, BIS has formulated more than 230 Indian standards, including minimum performance requirement standards of tractor, combine harvester, rotary tiller or rotavator, and power tiller. These standards play an important role in implementing the subsidy schemes of Government of India for agricultural machineries.
IS 15806 provides performance requirements of combined harvester with a straw management system. The straw management system is an auxiliary which is attached to combined harvester, which cuts straw into small pieces and spreads the same. With this method, farmers are not required to burn the paddy straw before sowing the next crop. This results in only one process for both harvesting of crop and management of stubble. Since the management of stubble has already been taken care of during harvesting, so there will be no burning of stubble, which helps in prevention of air pollution. IS 12207 provides the assessment criteria of evaluative requirements applicable for qualifying minimum performance criteria of agricultural tractors. The minimum performance requirements of agricultural tractors are necessary to perform its intended use, which is performing actions like ploughing, harrowing, etc. In the standard, there is classification on critical and non-critical breakdown, which are crucial during testing to facilitate testing authorities for conducting various performance tests.
In the area of farm irrigation and drainage systems, BIS has formulated Indian standards on all the components of micro irrigation systems such as sprinkler, emitters, pipes, filters, etc.
Micro irrigation works on the principle of applying only the required quantity of water to the crops. Irrigation equipment such as sprinklers, emitters, pipes and filters are mainly made from polyethylene. Polyethylene tends to degrade when exposed to sunlight because of ultraviolet radiations of the sunlight. Thus, while formulating standards, special attention was provided to requirement of UV stabilizers. Further, its uniform distribution is also important. To take care of this, carbon dispersion test is included. The most common and effective UV stabilizer is carbon black.
BIS has formulated standards covering quality specifications for pesticides, including insecticides, herbicides, fungicides, biologicals, and plant growth regulators. Standards have been formulated on pesticides formulations, whether as vegetable powders, emulsifiable concentrates, liquids, or granules, and other items relating to pest control, including safety. Some of the important requirements for pesticide formulations include moisture content, acidity, alkalinity, flash point, bulk density, etc. Standards have also been developed on the equipment used for post-harvest operations, such as shelling, milling, oil expellers, grain dryers, and food processing. These machineries help in providing better quality crop with minimum loss in terms of broken grains for storage. Chaff cutter is an important machine used by farmers to cut the chaff for feeding their cattle. IS-7898 provides material, construction, and other requirements for manually operated chaff cutter. In the standard, the materials for parts have been mentioned as per their intended and implied use. Flywheel, feed rolls, and other requirements have been provided to ensure better performance and safety.
In the area of agricultural systems and farm practices, BIS has formulated standards on sustainable agricultural practices or India GAP, organic farming, also on plasticulture, protected agriculture, and precision farming. Standards have also been developed on surface covered cultivation components, greenhouse structure, and polyhouse films.
The Standard on Good Agricultural Practices, also known as GAP, IS-15930 for crop-based provides a focused approach for implementing good agricultural practices, traceability, etc. Through appropriate infrastructure, record keeping, and monitoring, which helps in farm management based on observing, measuring, and responding to inter and intra field variability in crops. Implementation of the standard helps in development of basic infrastructure at the field level, provides a uniform approach across the farms regardless of the sizes, helps to increase awareness among the farmers as well as the consumers about the need for consumption of good quality and safe food. Traceability through complete integration of food chain, improvement in the environment as well as soil fertility and worker safety and welfare. This also greatly enhances the reputation in the international market as a producer of good quality and safe produce.
BIS has formulated 112 Indian standards on cereals, pulses, and their products. Standards have been developed for various aspects ranging from product specifications, methods of sampling, and test to code of practices to be followed for safe storage of food grains.
BIS has published a series of Indian standards on various aspects of food grain storage, such as storage structures and storage management code. We have standardized food grain storage structures ranging from domestic storage bins to large storage godowns. IS-16144, Indian Standard on Food Grain Storage Godown, is an important standard in this series. IS-16144 covers the basic requirements of food grain storage godowns like location, its capacity and dimensions, foundation, floors and walls, doors, ventilation and drainage, lighting, ancillary structures and other facilities. This standard helps to guide warehousing organizations in developing effective storage structures to reduce post-harvest losses and thereby improving the food security and agricultural infrastructure in the country.
In the area of spices and condiments, BIS has formulated 72 standards covering product specifications for spices, dried herbs, oleo resins, methods of test and sampling, terminology for spices, code of hygienic practices for processing units.
Indian standards on important spices like black pepper, cardamom, turmeric, cumin, and curry powder cover requirements for safety and quality parameters such as moisture content, ash content, acid-insoluble ash, added starch, crude fiber, volatile oil content, extraneous matter, limits for metallic contaminants, limits for additives if used, limits for microbiological parameters, etc. Recommendations for packaging and storage of spices are also given. In addition to these, spice oleoresin standards have specified parameters like color value, residual solvent content, and content of bioactive compounds of relevant spice.
Through BIS, India is taking a leading role in the world of international standardization of spices. BIS has the ISO Secretariat for the Subcommittee ISOTC 34SC7 on spices, culinary herbs and condiments for more than 5 decades. ISO member countries participate in this committee for standardization in the field of spices, culinary herbs and condiments. Edible oils and fats are an integral part of daily cuisines around the world.
BIS has laid down standards for principal edible oils such as mustard oil, soybean oil, coconut oil, palm oil and blended edible vegetable oils, among several others. These standards define the grades for final products and specify their quality parameters such as moisture content, color, refractive index, saponification value, iodine value, acid value, unsaponifiable matter, flash point, etc. Requirements for labeling are also specified in these standards along with references to methods of analysis for which separate standards have been laid down. Indian standard IS 548 along with its various parts and their sections prescribe test methods for important characteristics and quality and safety parameters for oils and fats including fatty acid profile, oxidative stability, triacylglycerol composition, content of polar compounds, fatty acid bound chloropropane diols, that is MCPDs and glycidol.
In order to facilitate and safeguard the trade and quality control of tobacco, Indian standards pertaining to tobacco and tobacco products, glossary of tobacco products, methods of sampling and test are formulated by BIS. The product standards on smoking and non-smoking products prescribe requirements like moisture content, total alkaloid content, ash content, acid-insoluble ash, etc. BIS has formulated almost 150 standards on animal feedstuffs, mineral mixtures, compounded feeds and feed supplements. Compliance to Indian standards on animal feed not only ensures that recommended nutrient requirements for the animals are fulfilled, but also that the feed is free from any harmful constituents.
Here, Indian standard IS 2052 for compounded cattle feeds is very relevant. This standard specifies limits for feed characteristics such as moisture, crude protein, crude fat, crude fiber, acid-insoluble ash, aflatoxin B1, etc. For poultry feeds, BIS has formulated Indian standard IS 1374. This standard, while specifying nutritional requirements like minerals, vitamins, amino acids, fatty acids, also prescribes upper limits for harmful substances like heavy metals, insecticides and aflatoxin B1.
BIS has developed around 136 Indian standards in the field of dairy. These include standards on all principal milk and milk products, whether semi-processed or processed, intended for distribution to the consumer, hygienic requirements for the dairy industry, chemical and microbiological methods of test and specification for dairy equipment. The product standards cover packaged pasteurized milk, flavored milk, sterilized milk and milk products such as milk powder, condensed milk, cheese, paneer, infant foods, ice cream, amongst several others.
Indian standard IS 13688 prescribes the requirements, methods of test and sampling for various types of packaged pasteurized milk. This standard, along with specifying the quality and safety requirements for the final product, which includes the content of milk fat, SNF, limits of aflatoxin M1, heavy metals and microbiological load also specifies requirements for raw milk intended for pasteurization. Specifications for fortified packaged pasteurized milk have also been given in this standard. This is a very important Indian standard, IS 1479 Part 1, developed by BIS, which describes the rapid methods for analysis of milk. These methods are normally required for assessing the quality of raw milk supplies intended for processing and manufacture. This standard has been referred in almost all the dairy product standards. BIS has also formulated Indian standard on bulk milk cooling tanks, which plays an important role in maintaining the cold chain of milk from the dairy farmer to the milk processing plants. This standard specifies the requirements for design, construction, and performance of bulk milk cooling tanks for fixed installations in farms or at milk collecting points.
In order to ensure that meat, poultry, and fish products reach the consumer in a fresh and hygienic state, BIS has developed 126 standards in this area.
Standards exist on various meat and poultry products covering fresh, chilled, frozen and canned. Key products like ham, bacon, mutton and chivon are also covered. The important requirements covered in meat and fish standards includes limits of metallic contaminants, preservatives, hygiene and microbiological requirements such as E. coli, aerobic plate count, salmonella, yeast and mold count, etc. BIS has formulated Indian standards for good aquaculture practices for shrimp, prawn, catfish and cage culture in freshwater. These standards prescribe control points and compliance criteria for different processes and inputs in aquaculture like site selection, soil and water management, equipment and infrastructure, materials and design of cages, species selection, seed availability, stocking, feed management, disease management, harvesting protocols, training, record keeping, certification, traceability, etc. Implementation of these standards would reap broad benefits like increased returns to the farmer producing safe and quality product, traceability through complete integration of food chain, overcoming the technical barrier to trade, improved sustainability and productivity.
In the apiary sector, BIS has formulated standards on extracted honey, beeswax, and royal jelly. BIS has also formulated standards on implements used in apiary, such as honey extractor, wasp trap, package bee box, etc.
In order to maintain safety and quality of fruits, vegetables, and their products, BIS has formulated 92 Indian standards. In this sector, we have formulated standards on processed fruits and vegetables, such as canned products, frozen products, dried fruits and nuts, fruit juices, etc. Under standardization, we have also covered test methods pertaining to fruits and vegetables. One such Indian standard is IS 2860, which prescribes the method of sampling as well as methods of physical, chemical and microbiological analysis of processed fruits and vegetables. Apart from product specifications and test methods, we have also formulated standards on very important aspects of fruits and vegetable supply chain, like ripening, storage, and transportation of raw vegetables and fruits. Such standards prescribe conditions of harvesting and ripening, methods of storage and transportation. One of the important Indian standards on this subject is IS 6028. Which specifies conditions for successful storage of green bananas in the pre-climacteric phase prior to its ripening. Therefore, we have standardized value-added products as well as the preservation processes of raw vegetables and fruits.
Standards have also been developed on tea, coffee, and cocoa, covering their requirements to ensure a good quality beverage and prescribing methods of testing for these products.
Indian standard IS 3633 prescribes the requirements, methods of test and sampling for black tea. The standard also specifies the plant source from which black tea is to be manufactured, description of the product, processing aids that may be used for manufacture of black tea, and quality characteristics of the product, that is, water extract, total ash, water soluble ash, acid insoluble ash, and crude fiber, along with the limits of iron filings, heavy metals, and pesticide residues.
With the rise in demand of convenience foods, or as we call them, ready-to-eat foods, it is important to ensure the safety and quality of such commodities at the consumer end. These foods are generally reheated, portioned or garnished, or food that undergoes similar finishing prior to being served.
BIS has developed Indian standards in this area, covering special purpose foods and specialized products, processed nutritious food, snack foods, protein isolates, bakery, confectionery products, and all types of ready-to-eat foods and related items. Special purpose foods are foods that have been designed to perform a specific function, such as to replace a meal which necessitates a content of essential nutrients which cannot be achieved except by addition of one or more of these nutrients. IS 17068 is one of the important standards, as it demonstrates guidelines for formulated supplementary foods for older infants and young children. It specifies the nutritional aspects such as protein, fat, carbohydrate and vitamins.
Related to the sugar industry, BIS has formulated 35 Indian standards covering sugar, jaggery and their test methods. Further, the standards for machinery used in the sugar industry are also formulated by the BIS. Important standards developed includes raw sugar, plantation white sugar, refined sugar and cube sugars. These standards specify the requirement such as polarization percentage, moisture, reducing sugar and sulfur dioxide content.
BIS has also developed Indian standards on various types of alcoholic beverages, including wine, whiskies, beer, rum, toddy, fenny. Besides these product specifications, BIS has standardized methods of sampling, testing, sensory evaluation of alcoholic beverages, as well as code of practice. A total of 21 Indian standards exist in this area. IS 14348 recommends the hygienic conditions required for establishing and maintaining alcoholic beverage producing units. Food additives are substances added to food to enhance its color, texture, flavor, and also improve its keeping quality. A total of 103 Indian standards have been formulated by BIS under this category.
Quality standards on food additives such as synthetic and natural food colors, preservatives, mold inhibitors, acidity regulators, improvers, flour treatment agents, artificial sweeteners, emulsifying and stabilizing agents, etc. have been formulated. An important Indian standard in this category is IS 7224, which specifies requirements and the method of sampling and testing for iodized salt, vacuum evaporated iodized salt and refined iodized salt. Important requirements covered in this standard include moisture content, water insoluble matter, chloride content, iodine content, etc.
BIS has formulated three basic standards for drinking water, namely packaged drinking water, packaged natural mineral water and piped drinking water. These standards specify various requirements including organoleptic, physical, chemical, toxic substances, radioactive residues and microbiological parameters for the water offered for human consumption in packaged form. These standards also prescribe the hygienic practices in accordance with which source water shall be collected, processed, handled, packaged and marketed.
Water is essential for life. So are standards on water quality. Indian Standard for Packaged Drinking Water, IS 14543, is a very important and popular Indian standard. It permits various water treatments such as decantation, filtration, removal of minerals, addition of useful minerals, reverse osmosis, etc. Packaged natural mineral water is not subjected to any treatment other than those permitted by Indian Standard IS 13428. Indian Standard for Drinking Water, IS 10500, is another important standard formulated by FAD 14, which is applicable for water from any source, treated or untreated, supplied by any means for human consumption. The requirements in this standard are at par with WHO guidelines for drinking water quality.
Use of water purification systems for drinking purposes become necessary to get clean and safe drinking water so that you stay away from waterborne diseases. In this area, BIS has formulated important standards. IS 14724 for ultraviolet water disinfection system and IS 16240 for reverse osmosis based point of use water treatment system specification. Food hygiene is of utmost importance, not only at home, but also at premises of all food businesses which handle food. In this regard, BIS is engaged in formulating standards that lay down hygienic practices to be followed by these food businesses to prevent consumers from suffering from food poisoning and allergic reactions, help minimize food waste and boost efficiency.
IS 2491 is the Indian standard, which provides principles of food hygiene applicable to be followed by food businesses to ensure that the food is safe and suitable for human consumption. The areas examined under IS 2491 include primary production, establishment design and facilities, control of operation, maintenance and sanitation, personal hygiene, transportation, product information, and consumer awareness and training. This standard is referred in all food product standards as the basic hygienic code to be followed by all businesses operating in the food chain to ensure food safety. Another important standard formulated covers the codex-based HACCP system, Hazard Analysis and Critical Control Points, HACCP, IS 15000-2013. This is a science-based and proactive system which identifies, evaluates and controls all hazards, physical, chemical, biological, which are significant for food safety. HACCP focuses on prevention rather than end product testing. It can be applied to the entire chain from farm to table.
Going further, BIS has also adopted the ISO standard, ISO 22000-2018 on FSMS, which sets out the requirements for a food safety management system to enable an organization to be certified to it. It outlines what an organization needs to do to demonstrate its ability to control food safety hazards in order to ensure that food is safe. By means of auditable requirements, it combines the HACCP plan with prerequisite programs.
BIS has recently formulated IS 17453-2020, which is meant for food safety and hygiene, code of practice for food businesses during epidemic pandemic situations with a specific reference to COVID-19. This standard specifies the essential food safety, respiratory hygiene, personal hygiene and social distancing practices that must be followed by any food businesses operator during COVID-19 pandemic. The standard also includes checklist for COVID-19 prevention for large retail service store, kirana store, food service, takeaway, delivery, transport, distribution, warehouse and manufacturing etc. that may be used to ensure the proper hygienic conditions in the premises.
Ayurveda, the science of life, is one among the 6 Indian systems of medicine recognized by the Government of India. By virtue of having its roots in Atharva Veda, this is perhaps the most ancient system of medicine which has been taking care of the ailing mankind. There is no denying the fact that this system of medicine has stood the test of time. It is even more relevant during the present scenario. However, there is an ardent need to validate this ancient wisdom on the basis of modern scientific parameters. With this objective, the Bureau of Indian Standards has collaborated with the Ministry of Ayush to formulate standards on Ayurveda. Till date, several standards on Ayurvedic terminology have already been published and several other standards are in pipeline. These primarily include the standards related to ingredients which go in Ayurvedic medicines, the standards related to equipment which are used in Ayurveda therapeutics, and the standards regarding the procedures which are adopted by Ayurveda doctors in treating their patients.
You have heard from our team on the range of work being carried out in the department. We constantly strive to keep ourselves abreast of the advancements that are happening in the food as well as agriculture sector, not only in the country but globally also. In this direction, BIS has come out with the Standards National Action Plan or SNAP, with the objective of identification of standardization needs and harmonizing the standardization activities at the national level. Now, to meet these objectives in the food and agriculture sector, we have identified subjects on which standards are required to be developed or existing standards revised. One important area is sustainable agriculture, and we are now focusing on developing specifications for biopesticides and biofertilizers, including nano-based formulations. At the same time, to keep pace with technology, we have already taken up the work to formulate standards for the use of electronics in agriculture, including smart agriculture, traceability in food, agriculture, and aquaculture systems. Further, to minimize wastage of agricultural produce, existing standards on food grain storage structures have been taken up for revision on priority. We are also coming out with guidelines for storage and hygienic transport of various fruit and vegetables so as to enhance their shelf life. Developing specifications for various dairy equipment like pasteurizers, sterilizers, cleaning in place systems. Also, in order to ensure the quality and safety of water for human consumption, standards are being developed for various types of membrane-based water purification systems for both domestic and industrial use. Also, across all the areas, we are now incorporating the latest instrumental test methods for determination of various micronutrients in foods like vitamins and minerals, and also test methods for heavy metal contaminants in various food matrices, and developing multi-residue test methods for determination of pesticide residues in food and agriculture products, along with other test methods for the product parameters.
So, every time you consume food in India, remember that BIS has made a contribution to it.
Think quality, think BIS.
To know more about the program and details of the department and its functions, you can visit our website. From the website, you can download all our indigenous standards free of cost.
The BIS e-governance portal, Manak Online, provides a comprehensive view of its activities, including on standardization. This portal serves BIS technical committee members and also other users of Indian standards. Filters to view the aspect-wise Indian standards classified based on test methods, product specifications, codes of practices, etc. is also available. The list of Indian standards relevant to various ministries and departments can also be accessed online. Details of published Indian standards and draft standards open for public commenting are also available. Proposals can also be submitted through the portal to make new Indian standards. Details about the technical committees, members, and their affiliations through Manak Online are just one click away.
Thank you.